Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Kovilvenni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the subject fluid mechanics and machines. And this is lecture number 7.3. We are going to solve problems in the boundary layer theory. In the earlier two lectures, we discussed about the boundary layer formation, boundary layer thickness. We defined and calculated the displacement thickness, momentum thickness, energy thickness, boundary layer equations, Von-Karman equation, laminar boundary layer, turbulent boundary layer and boundary layer separation. These are all the theoretical concepts we studied earlier in the two lectures. And in this lecture, we will be solving problem in the boundary layer theory. So, the learning outcome to the students, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problems in the boundary layer theory. Example number 1 from May 2010 and 2013 question paper. The velocity distribution in a boundary layer is given by small u by capital U equal to y by delta. So small u is the velocity at any location, capital U is the velocity, the maximum velocity, which is equal to y is the position and delta is the boundary layer thickness. Capital U is the free steam velocity. So where u is the velocity at a distance y from the plate, small u equal to capital U at y equal to delta, that is the boundary condition. So delta being the boundary layer thickness. So find the displacement thickness, momentum thickness and energy thickness. So the value given, we are given the boundary layer, velocity distribution, small u by capital U equal to y by delta. So first we calculate the displacement thickness. So displacement thickness, delta star is defined as, it is given by integral 0 to delta 1 minus small u by capital U into dy. So the u is the velocity profile. So small u is the velocity at any location, capital U is the free steam velocity. Now it is given u by capital U equal to y by delta. We substitute here delta star equal to integral 0 to delta 1 minus y by delta dy. So integrating 1 it is y. Integrating y, it is y square by 2 delta. So, delta is the denominator. Integrating y equal to y square by 2. So, the limit is 0 to delta. So, substituting limit. So, y delta minus delta square by 2 delta, which is delta minus delta by 2, which is delta by 2. The answer is this delta by 2. So, displacement thickness for the given velocity profile is delta by 2, where delta is the boundary layer thickness. Then, momentum thickness. Momentum thickness theta is defined by integral 0 to delta small u by capital U into 1 minus small u by capital U dy. Once again, we substitute the value of u by capital U. So, integral 0 to delta y by delta into 1 minus y by delta dy. So, taking the y by delta into the bracket, so y by delta minus y square by delta square dy. Now, integrating theta equal to y square by 2 delta minus y cube by 3 delta square. So, substitute the limit 0 to delta. So, this is delta square by 2 delta minus delta cube by 3 delta square. So, simplifying, first one becomes delta by 2, second one becomes delta by 3 and the answer is delta by 6. So, simplifying, calculating theta equal to delta by 6. So, the momentum thickness theta equal to delta by 6. Then, the energy thickness delta star equal to integral 0 to delta u by u into 1 minus u square by u square dy. So, substituting small u by capital U equal to y by delta, so integral 0 to delta y by delta into 1 minus y square by delta square dy. And taking y by delta into the bracket, so delta star equal to integral 0 to delta y by delta minus y cube by delta cube dy. Integrating y square by 2 delta minus y power 4 divided by 4 delta to the power 3. The limits are 0 to delta. So, substituting limit delta square by 2 delta minus delta power 4 by 4 delta cube, that is delta by 2 minus delta by 4 equal to delta by 4. The answer is delta by 4. Example number 2 from May 2010 question paper. A smooth flat plate is placed in number 1, a stream of water with a velocity of 4 meters per second. Number 2, a stream of air with a velocity of 4 meters per second. And number 3, a stream of air with a velocity of 9 meters per second. Compare the growth of laminar boundary layer in 3 cases. Take the mass density of water 1000 kilogram per meter cube, dynamic viscosity of water 0.001 newton second per meter square, mass density of air 1.2 kilogram per meter cube and dynamic viscosity of air 19 into 10 power minus 6 newton second by meter square. So the values are given. Velocity of water is 4 meters per second, velocity of air is 4 meters per second and the air is also 9 meters per second, density of water is 1000 kilogram per meter cube, absolute viscosity of water 0.001 newton second per meter square, density of air 1.2 kilogram per meter cube and the dynamic viscosity of air 19 into 10 power minus 6 newton second by meter square. Now we take the first case, a stream of water with velocity 4 meters per second. We calculate the Reynolds number. Limiting Reynolds number for the laminar flow in a flat plate is 5 into 10 power 5. Reynolds number is defined by rho u l divided by mu, which is 5 into 10 power 5. So from the definition of Reynolds number, we calculate the length up to which the flow will be laminar. So Reynolds number into mu divided by rho into u, which is 5 into 10 power 5 into 0.001 divided by 1000 into 4, which is 0.125 meter. So delta equal to 5 into L divided by square root of Reynolds number. So 5 into 0.125 divided by 5 into 10 power 5 equal to 0.00088 meter, which is 0.88 millimeter. So the boundary thickness for water flow with the velocity is 0.88 millimeter. Then the stream of air with the velocity of 4 meters per second. Again the Reynolds number is rho ul by mu equal to 5 into 10 power 5 for the flat plate. So we calculate the length here. Length equal to Reynolds number into mu divided by rho u, 5 into 10 power 5 into 19 into 10 power minus 6 divided by 1.2 into u, which is 1.98 meter. Now we calculate delta equal to 5L by square root of Reynolds number, 5 into 1.98 divided by square root of 5 into 10 power 5 equal to 0.014 meter, which is 14 millimeter. For air, the boundary layer thickness is 14 millimeter. Then the stream of air with the velocity of 9 meters per second. So we take once again Reynolds number equal to rho UL by mu, which is 5 into 10 power 5. Now the length equal to Reynolds number into mu divided by rho into u, 5 into 10 power 5 into 19 into 10 power minus 6 divided by 1.2 into 9, which is 0.88 meter. Now the delta equal to 5L by square root of Reynolds number. So 5 into 0.88 divided by square root of 5 into 10 power 5 equal to 6.22 into 10 power minus 3, which is 6.22 millimeter. So the boundary layer thickness for air, comparing with the air, lower velocity, we have higher boundary thickness, higher velocity, the boundary thickness is reducing, and for liquid, it is still lower, for 4 meters per second, the velocity boundary thickness is very, very small. The next example from November 2011, water is flowing over a thin, smooth plate of length 5 meter and the width 2.5 meter at a velocity of 1 meters per second. If the boundary layer flow changes from laminar to turbulent at Reynolds number equal to 5 into 10 power 5, find the distance from the leading edge up to which the flow is laminar, thickness of the boundary layer at the transition point and the drag force on one side of the plate. Take the viscosity of water is 0.01 poise. So we are given length equal to 5 meter, width b equal to 2.5 meter, u velocity equal to 1 meters per second. The limiting Reynolds number is 5 into 10 power 5, mu dynamic viscosity of the fluid is water is 0.01 poise, which is 0.001 newton second by meter square. Now we calculate the distance from the leading edge up to which the flow is laminar. So Reynolds number equal to rho ux divided by mu, which is 5 into 10 power 5. X is the distance up to which the flow is laminar. So now x equal to Reynolds number into u, Reynolds number into mu divided by rho into u, which is 5 into 10 power 5 into 0.001 divided by 1000 into 1 equal to 0.5 meter. So the total length of the plate is 5 meter. So up to 0.5 meter the flow is laminar, then it becomes turbulent. And thickness of the boundary layer at the transition point. So delta equal to 5x divided by square root of Reynolds number. So 5 into 0.5 divided by square root of 5 into 10 power 5 equal to 3.53 into 10 power minus 3 meter, which is 3.53 millimeter. Now the drag force. So this is the boundary layer. So total length of the plate is 5 meter, A to C. A to B, the flow is lambda, then the flow becomes turbulent, and the X we calculate as 5.5 meter. Now the drag force for the entire plate, one side of the plate, drag force for the laminar bound layer plus the drag force for the turbulent bound layer from B to C. So up to A to B, the flow is laminar, B to C, the flow becomes turbulent. Now we calculate one by one. The drag force for the laminar bound layer, AB. So first we calculate the drag coefficient, CD equal to 1.328 divided by square root of Reynolds number. So which is 1.328 divided by 5 in 10 power 5 equal to 1.88 in 10 power minus 3. That is the CD value. Then the drag force between A and B. So from the drag coefficient, drag force equal to CD into 1 by 2 rho A u square. Rho is the density, A is the area of the plate, and the u square is the velocity. So CD into 1 by 2, the area equal to B into X. So B is the width of the plate, X is the length up to the flow where the flow is lambda, and the u square is the velocity square. So substituting 1.88 10 power minus 3 into 1 by 2 into 1000 into 2.5 into 0.5 into 1 square equal to 1.175 Newton. And the drag force for the turbulent bound layer AB. So first we consider the entire length is turbulent. Entire length is turbulent. Then we take the first AB is turbulent. So the CD, now we calculate first AB, consider AB as a turbulent flow. So CD will be, for turbulent flow, CD equal to 0.074 divided by Reynolds number to the power 0.2. So 0.074 divided by 5 in 10 power 5 to the power 0.2 equal to 5.36 in 10 power minus 3. Now the drag force for the turbulent bound layer, considering AB is up to A to B, it is turbulent bound layer. So CD into 1 by 2 rho A u square, which is CD into 1 by 2 rho into B into X into u square. So calculating 5.36 into 10 power minus 3 into 1 by 2 into 1000 into 2.5 into 0.5 into 1 square equal to 3.35 Newton. Now we take the drag force, calculate the drag force for the entire length from A to C. So A to C, Reynolds number equal to rho u L divided by mu. Length, we have to consider the entire length. So 1000 into 1 into 5 divided by 0.001 equal to 5 into 10 power 6. So the Reynolds number at the point C, it is 5 into 10 power 6. Now CD equal to, again for turbulent flow, 0.074 divided by Reynolds number to the power 0.2, which is 0.074 divided by 5 into 10 power 6 to the power 0.2 equal to 3.38 into 10 power minus 3. Now the drag force for the entire length of the plate, the assuming the entire length is turbulent flow. CD into 1 by 2 rho A u square. So CD into 1 by 2 rho into B into L into u square. So 3.38 10 power minus 3 into 1 by 2. Rho is 1000. B equal to 2.5. Length equal to 5 meter. And the u square equal to 1 square. Which is 21.125. Now the drag force between B, C. That is equal to drag force between A and C. And minus drag force between A and B. So which is 21.125 minus 3.35 equal to 17.775 Newton. So the drag force between BC equal to 17.775 Newton. Now the drag force for the entire plate, the drag force for the laminar flow between AB and the drag force for the turbulent flow between BC, that we have to add. So the drag force equal to drag force for the laminar flow AB plus drag force for the turbulent flow BC. So 1.175 plus 17.775 equal to 18.95 Newton. Example number 4 from November 2012 question paper. A plate of 600 mm length and 400 mm wide is immersed in a fluid of specific gravity 0.9 and kinematic viscosity 10 power minus 4 meter square per second. The fluid is moving with a velocity 6 meters per second, determining the bound layer thickness, shear stress at the end of the plate, and drag force on one side of the plate. So length equal to 0.6 meter, width equal to 0.4 meter, specific gravity is 0.9, so the density is 900 kg per meter cube. So density equal to specific gravity into 1000. And the kinematic viscosity nu equal to 10 power minus 4 meter square per second, and velocity u equal to 6 meters per second. Now calculating Reynolds number equal to UL by nu, which is 6 into 0.6 divided by 10 power minus 4 equal to 3.6 in 10 power 4. So the flow is laminar. For flat plate, flow over the flat plate, the flow is laminar. The boundary layer thickness for laminar flow, so delta equal to 5L divided by square root of Reynolds number. So 5 into 0.6 divided by 3.6 into 10 power 4 equal to 0.0158 meter, which is 15.8 millimeter. Then the shear stress at the end of the plate, CD equal to, first we calculate the drag coefficient, CD equal to 0.664 divided by square root of Reynolds number, which is 0.664 divided by 3.6 into 10 power 4, which is 3.5 into 10 power minus 3. So the shear stress at the end of the plate, tau L equal to CD into 1 by 2 rho u square, which is 3.5 into 10 power minus 3 into 1 by 2 into 900 into 6 square equal to 56.7 newtons per meter square. Then the drag force on one side of the plate, again we have to calculate the coefficient, drag coefficient, average drag coefficient, which is 1.328 divided by square root of Reynolds number. So which is 1.328 divided by square root of 3.6 into 10 power 4 equal to 7 into 10 power minus 3. Now the drag force equal to F equal to CD into 1 by 2 rho A u square, where CD into 1 by 2 rho A equal to B into L into u square. So 7 into 10 power minus 3 into 1 by 2 into 900 into 0.4 into 0.6 into 6 square equal to 27.22 newton. That is the drag force on one side of the plate. The example number 5, air is flowing over a flat plate of 5 meter long and 3 meter wide with a velocity of 5 meters per second at 15 degrees Celsius. Take the density of the air is 1.208 kilogram per meter cube and the kinematic viscosity is 0.147 stoke. Calculate length of the plate over which the boundary layer is laminar and thickness of the boundary layer for laminar flow. Shear stress at the location where the boundary layer ceases to be laminar and total drag force on both sides of the laminar boundary layer. So we are given L equal to 5 meter, B width equal to 3 meter, density of the air 1.208 kilogram per meter cube, kinematic viscosity is 0.147 stroke, which is 0.147 10 power minus 4 meter square per second, and the u velocity equal to 5 meters per second. The length of the plate over which the boundary layer is laminar and thickness of the laminar boundary layer. Now, Reynolds number. So, the limiting Reynolds number for laminar flow is 5 into 10 power 5 for the flat flow over flat plate. U into x divided by nu equal to 5 into 10 power 5. So, we calculate the length up to which the flow is laminar. So, x equal to Reynolds number into nu divided by u, 5 into 10 power 5 into 0.147 into 10 power 4 divided by 5. So this becomes 1.47 meter. So in the total length of the plate is 5 meter, but the length up to which the flow is laminar is 1.47 meter. Then the boundary layer thickness for laminar flow, delta equal to 5x divided by square root of Reynolds number, which is 5 into 1.47 divided by square root of 5 into 10 power 5, which is 0.0104, which is 1.04 centimeter. Shear stress at the location where the boundary layer ceases to be laminar. So, up to the boundary layer, end of the boundary layer, laminar boundary layer, we have to calculate the shear stress. So, CD, drag coefficient at the location, at the particular location is 0.664 divided by square root of Reynolds number, which is 0.664 divided by 5 in 10 power 5 equal to 9.39 10 power minus 4. And the tau O, so shear stress, wall shear stress, at the point where the flow is laminar, CD into 1 by 2 rho u square, 9.39 10 power minus 4 into 1 by 2 into 1.208 into u square equal to 5 square equal to 0.0141 newtons per meter square. Now the total drag force on both sides of the laminar boundary layer, first we have to calculate the average drag coefficient, CD equal to 1.328 divided by square root of Reynolds number, which is 1.328 divided by 5 into square root of 5 into 10 power 5 equal to 1.878 10 power 3. Now the drag force equal to 2 into CD. So 2 is included here in the equation to calculate the drag force on both sides of the plate. So 2 into CD into 1 by 2 rho A u square, which is 2 into CD into 1 by 2 rho into B into X. X is the position or length up to which the flow is laminar into u square. So 2 into 1.878 10 power minus 3 into 1 by 2 into 1.208 into 3 into 1.47 into 5 square equal to 0.25 newton. So this is the drag force on both sides of the plate. So we stop here. So these are all the books I published in mechanical engineering subject. You may find fluid mechanics and machinery book. You may refer to the book for additional problems in the boundary layer theory. And I upload all the video lectures of the subject in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, use the videos for your better learning. Thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me to my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. We'll meet again in another video lecture on the fluid mechanics and machinery. Until then, bye bye.